Hello everyone. Now our next point is notes on the get and set methods. Introduction of the get and set methods. So why we require the set and the get methods? So first the introduction is, what is the encapsulation? So encapsulation features indicates that sensitive data is hidden from the users, means outside world cannot access that private data. So to achieve this, declare class variables as private. We can declare the variables as private variables. Then provide the public get and set methods to access the value of the variable and update the value of the private variable. So private variables can only be accessed within the same class. That is, an outside class or outside world has no access it. That is, outside class cannot access that private variables. So suppose in that case we want that private variables to access. So at that situation, get and set method is used. So it is possible to access these private variables by using the public get and set methods. Now see here, what is the set method and the get method? So get method is used to return the value of the variable. Similarly, the set method is used to set the value of the variable. So there is a difference between the get and set method is that get method is used to get the value, but the set method is used to set the value of the variable. So what is the syntax for the get and set methods? So set and get methods are similarly syntax for both methods are same. There is a difference is that for using the get method, you have to write the keyword get, and for set method, you have to write the set keyword. So they start with either get or set, followed by the name of the variable with the first letter in uppercase. Suppose you want to get the name, then get the uppercase letter name n, and for using the set method, set and name of that name and the letter is uppercase letter is the n. For example, this is the name. So similarly, you can use also another, get the roll number, get the social security number, get the last name also, get the first name also. So all these kinds of the variables you can use the get and set methods. Now see here one simple example of this method. So there is a class person is there. In that person method, the name is variable is declared as a private variable, and whose return type is the string. So there is a get name method is also defined here. The access modifier is the public and the return type is the string. So here get method is defined, and in that the name is return, the value of the name is returns. So next there is a set name method is defined here. So set name method gets one parameter, that is new name. Okay, so this keyword is used here to assigning the new name value to the name. So the get method returns the value of the variable name, and the set method takes a parameter, that is new name, and assigns it to the name variable. So here this keyword is used here. This is used to refer to the current object. So as a name variable, in this example the name variable is declared as a private, so this private variable name cannot be accessed outside the class because this is a private. So outside world has no permission to access this private variable name. So to solve this problem, okay, we can use, suppose there is a class my class and there is a main method. In that main method, the object of the person class is created, and by using that object, the name I'm trying here the setting the value of the name variable, that is prim, and we are displaying this value by using the myobj.name by using the println statement here. But after we are compiling this error, running this error, compiling this program, then there will be an error, because the name variable is declared as a private in the class person. So myobj.name, there will be an error, and system.out.println myobj.name, there will be an error, because we are trying to access the private variable outside that class. So to solve this problem, we can use the set and get methods. So see here, the public class, my class, there is the same main method, and the person class is there, object is created. So now myobj.setName method is used here for setting the value of the variable name, and here println statement is used to get the value of the variable name. So set method is a method that updates the value of the variable, and get method is used that reads the value of the variable. So all these things about the set and get methods and how they are used in the program. Okay, thank you.